take four keen amateur chefs.
Right, I've had a disaster.
Ooh, I slipped up.
Over four nights, ask each to stage a dinner party.
I'm into Thai guys at the moment.
Throw in some spice.
Ooh. I've seen those before.
You've got beautiful come-to-bed eyes.
By making them rate each other's food.
It just tasted like a massage oil to me.
The result? The heat is on.
Oh, what? The woman's mental.
What a clever girl.
Jimmy Guinness over her head if she's not careful.
As they battle to win a £1,000 prize.
It's orgasmic.
I'm scared.
The final day when the winner will be revealed. And one person who's in with a chance of bagging the cash is our first cook, pub landlord James Paley.
You know, I'm a really competitive person, and for me to win would be brilliant. You know, I want to win more than anything.
Well, it's definitely so far so good, as James notched an impressive 22. Next came novelist and scientist Vera Phillips-Griffiths, who's starting to quake under the weight of the competition.
I do not think I'm going to win this competition. I really don't. My food was excellent, I think, but it was cold.
Yep, cold is most certainly bad, and it showed as Vera scored just 15. Yesterday, IT worker John Bramley stepped up to the plate.
I mean, my old heart's pumping, like, the first time I met the wife, you know, it's like, ooh. That tastes foul. In fact, that has to be the worst taste I've ever had.
Yet, miraculously, he's rather smug about his performance.
Last night was brilliant, as far as I was concerned. I got a real buzz out of it. I mean, to be honest, I'm still buzzing now. I haven't come down yet.
Well, enjoy it while you can, because you'll soon find out you haven't won after scoring 21. So leader James can only be beaten by our final chef, none other than brash and sassy veteran host Marie Hughes-Price.
Yes, yeah, I am a dinner party addict. That's my forte in life now. So, I don't think it'll be a problem to me. Conceited again, but there we go. If I can't be conceited, who can be?
One thing that might help you win this evening is making sure your guests stay awake.
Oh, my God. I've done that before.
I had my head down on the table for about half an hour. But then I was OK, it was fine.
Three glasses of cocktail and the way she was throwing that white wine down, I think had a small bit to do with it.
Me and James were in stitches. It was one of the funniest moments I've seen. Because it's Vera, she's just like that. She's just comically funny.
Good thing John can see the humour in some things, and so far this week he's not gelled with Marie.
She does like talking about herself quite a lot.
And that week, I don't buy them every week. They haven't got one.
Oh, for God's sake, can't you think of me?
Jimmy Guinness over her head if she's not careful in these days.
But her enthusiasm for John's cooking last night may have buttered him up.
Your meal was superb.
I think she enjoyed the food because she was, out of all the three dinner guests, she was the only one who finished every single course completely.
So is all the tension now diffused?
I'm not going to tell Marie what I think of her tonight because tonight is her night. It's her night to shine. So I wouldn't spoil someone's party like that.
That'll be a no, then. Not that Marie's noticed.
Oh, I'm getting on with John fine. He had a little dig at me the other night, but I think he was just a bit nervous.
Ah, ignorance is bliss. Marie is also very confident that her 40 years of cooking experience will help her snatch the prize.
I have splashed out. Because it cost, this dinner party will cost more than what my normal dinner parties cost.
The best is yet to come, come a day.
First bit of splashing out, a trip to visit her son's bistro for some wine.
Hello.
Hello, how are you? Good evening.
Yeah, it was lovely. I had a really nice time. Yeah?
You're not causing too many problems?
No, not yet. It's always tonight.
Right, remember to not to drink too much and keep the volume down.
Right, okay.
Okay.
It's great advice. Shame it's about 3 days too late.
So what are you cooking this evening?
I'm doing the smoked haddock fish cakes with the poached eggs and hollandaise sauce, which...
Don't poison them.
Why?
With the eggs.
Oh, no, they're cooked. I've actually cooked. You know, they're cooked, they're not just cold.
As you've just heard, Marie's starter is smoked haddock fish cakes with poached eggs.
Very posh.
I'm not overly keen on fish because if there's a bone, I won't eat the rest, but it is a fish cake.
Oh, I don't like smoked haddock and I don't like hollandaise sauce. Never mind.
But first job of the day is pudding. Marie's so determined to win, she's wowing her guests with a choice of two. Meringue with homemade elderflower ice cream and lemon syllabub.
I would probably go for the lemon syllabub because I find meringue very sugary.
Not sure what a syllabub is.
Maybe I can have both.
Yep, you certainly can.
So, first of all, I'm going to make some ice cream, OK? That's the first thing, which should have been done hours ago. We'll just have to hope it freezes for tonight.
She starts by boiling some milk. She whisks egg yolks, adds sugar.
Just needs to get a bit white rather than yellow if you're mixing it together. Although I did put an extra yolk in, so it could be quite yellow.
And then adds the warmed milk before returning to the heat.
I might put this into two containers and then it'll freeze quicker.
Ooh, very clever. And when the custard has thickened, she measures out her key ingredient.
Just elderflower cordial, that's all it is. And there's just enough there to make another portion.
She pours into tubs ready for the freezer. But haven't you forgotten something, Marie?
So that's plenty. So if there's any left over... Oh, I didn't put the elderflower. Oh, I slipped up. Right. Equal amounts. This is good, isn't it? So organised, aren't I?
Not really.
It's just a flavour, so it won't hurt.
The domestic goddess nearly lost her crown, and it's into the freezer to set.
Please freeze.
Next up, the lemon syllabub, which is a mixture of white wine, sugar, lemon juice and lemon zest. The mixture is then left to stand until it's whipped with cream at the last minute.
Overnight, if you like, but...
And finally, she whisks up some meringues. She still has time for a short lecture on cleanliness in the kitchen.
Some men, when they're cooking, and if they've got long hair, they do this all the time. They go like that all the time with their hair, and then they go onto the chopping board, and I think, oh, my God. There was a guy on the telly, and he had a builder's bum as well, you know, where, like, bending over when he's bending down at the cooker. And he'd get up and then put his hand in his hair, pull his trousers up under his big fat stomach, and then go and serve the food. I thought, oh, God, I couldn't eat that food. But there you go.
So nowhere to talk about your two biggest rivals.
I think I'm going to win. But if I don't win, then I would like James to win.
I think for me to win tonight, I think there's got to be a disaster in the kitchen.
I won't win. That's all I know.
But well, you're absolutely right there. Marie's now on to cooking her smoked haddock for the first course.
Because it's smoked, it doesn't need much cooking.
She then adds a mashed potato and spring onion mix, adds 3 ounces of cheese.
Dead on, how about that? What a clever girl.
Then the fish. And she rolls into little cakes covered in parsley and breadcrumbs to be grilled in the oven later. Now for the eggs.
Do you poach eggs now? You poach them as you need them. No, you don't. It's a tip. You poach them now, put them into iced water, put them in the fridge and just drain them off, put boiling water on just as you're laying everything out on a plate, and that just reheats them. Because they're cooked anyway, they can't go bad or anything.
With the starter under control, it's time to ply through her main course, biotin of chicken.
Chicken with a mustard sauce, pom puree sounds a little bit... poncy, because I think it's just going to be mashed potato. She might pipe it out, but, you know, it's still mash at the end of the day.
Yes, a bit disappointed with the chicken, because I thought she might have some nice beef, perhaps.
Why?
Beef, onion or something.
Don't know what a ballantine is. With mustard sauce and potato, pom puree, potato puree, that sounds nice, but anything chicken's nice to me. Served with fresh vegetables, that's playing it safe.
Marie starts by preparing her breasts for stuffing.
I didn't expect them to be this big. I am quite confident that this is going to be a winning menu. It's going to be lovely.
Then it's on to the stuffing. She starts by adding herbs to her sausage meat.
That would be too much. I've already prepared something I did earlier. I've just chopped some tarragon and some parsley. So.
And in go some apricots.
Yep.
Next, she spreads her stuffing onto the breasts and rolls them in cling film.
Oh, look, that's a big fat one.
Well, quite. She poaches the chicken parcels and will pan fry them for 5 minutes just before serving. Finally, it's judgment night for Marie, and all is calm in the kitchen.
Nice house, but I'm a bit curious who's going to answer the door, whether it be Marie or her Indonesian houseboy.
Hi, Marie.
Good evening.
First to arrive is John, and it looks like last night's buttering up has paid off.
This is for you.
Oh, thank you.
Lovely. Friendship.
Thank you. Oh, lovely.
Next in is Vera.
Hello, Princess.
Hello, Marie.
And last in, it's the one to beat, James.
Good evening.
Good evening, Marie.
Look at this. Whee!
There we go.
Oh, thank you.
Physical on tonight.
Oh, it's lovely.
I was telling Marie I had a lovely surprise for her later.
I'm going to keep it quiet for the moment.
I'm not going to tell her what it is.
It's not going to shock me, is it?
No, I wouldn't. Well, I wouldn't. No, surprise you, but not shock you.
Shock you, OK, that's all right.
Is not a male stripper, is it, Vera? Coming up, Vera reveals her big surprise.
It's Alan Sugar, actually. I asked him to pop in.
Quite frankly, it was pointless.
James reveals his weakness.
Here we go.
And Marie reveals the winner of the £1,000.
Whee!
It's the final night of the competition, and although no one knows it, James is currently in line to win the £1,000 prize. But today's host, Marie, is determined to snatch the cash with her well-practiced menu. With Marie occupied in the kitchen, her guests take a tour of the house.
Shall I go upstairs?
What's this first?
To Marie?
Cliff Richard.
I can't believe this.
Then it's upstairs to the master bedroom's ensuite.
Jacuzzi bath.
This is brilliant.
Yes. Oh,
this is, you know, kind of. And look.
Yeah, it's a spa, isn't it?
Yes. Yeah, oh. My wife would die for something like this.
That's a bit extreme, don't you think?
I reckon there's a his and hers bathroom.
Do you think
so?
Good
shout, mate, yeah.
And they're off through the bedroom to find out.
They hardly have two bathrooms.
That would be a walk-in closet.
Yeah?
Yeah, walk-in closet.
Oh, gosh. I can't believe this.
Nice. This is lovely.
Oh, how wonderful.
I can hear footsteps upstairs, so they're obviously having a route around in my boudoir. And there's nothing they could find, because I've hidden everything.
I could live in it.
Yes, just imagine something.
I've rented smaller rooms before. Like have you seen how her husband has one belt for every trouser? Because I have one belt for all my trousers.
Well, he might say the same about your necklace collection.
This is the pièce de résistance.
Back downstairs, she takes the eggs out of the fridge, covers in hot water to reheat and drains. I never seen it done that way. Fingers crossed it works.
This is a good one. Dinner is about to be served, so if you'd like to come to the dining room with me...
Come on, boys.
And hey presto, smoked haddock fish cakes with poached eggs and hollandaise sauce.
This was very nice, Marie, to be honest with you.
Well, I never asked you if you like hollandaise, but I put it on anyway.
Mm. Marie, I have a confession to make.
Yes.
You're kinky.
I think we know that already.
Oh, heck, it's not the male stripper already, is it?
A business friend of mine has just flown up into Birmingham tonight.
Yeah.
It's Alan Sugar, actually.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, and I asked him to pop in. Is that OK?
That's no problem.
Yeah?
I'm glad and Mike isn't here. You can't stand him.
He's...
Well, that didn't seem to faze Marie, but maybe this will.
You got a bone?
I got a bone.
Sorry.
And things are about to go from bad to worse.
Me.
I like the egg on top.
It's nice when it infuses into the smoked haddock. Allergic.
Well, it looks like Marie's had her first major hiccup for the evening.
Probably a bit of bread got stuck. It's not the... That's what it is.
That's never a bit of bread. It's one down and two to go, same as the courses, really.
I didn't see James just disappear off to the toilet to relieve himself of her starter. However, I heard him relieving himself of her starter.
I was dipping my bread in the poached egg and had a mouthful, thought, looked down and the rest of the bit fell off the bread and it was actually raw.
I did feel sorry for Marie because obviously it's like she'd done something wrong. But there again, maybe she was trying to poison the competition. I don't know.
Now, that egg wasn't any more undercooked than any of the others. Because it was cooked earlier, it was warmed up, and they were overcooked in a bit, you know. They weren't overcooked, but it wasn't runny, so he just didn't like it. It's fine. But
I'm not bitter.
Moving on from the starter, let's hope Marie's dinner party goes down a bit more smoothly from now on. And stays down. Marie mashes some potatoes for the pommes puree.
The cream in it? I'll just put that little bit in.
And she's not going to risk her guests complaining about a lumpy mash.
Very nice.
Finally, she pan-fries her poached chicken breasts. For her main course, Marie is serving biotine of chicken with mustard sauce and pommes puree.
Actually, this chicken
delicious.
Is really tender.
Mm. Well, it looks like James has survived round two.
From the choice of the menu, it was very sort of 70s, early 80s, you know, from, you know, sort of Fanny Craddock type thing.
It's very difficult to get chicken with a good taste. So I wouldn't put that on a menu for anybody.
I thought the chicken was well cooked. I did enjoy the stuffing that she did, the apricot, and I still remember the apricot. That was really nice. I actually asked at the table how she'd done it because that's something that I would like to do myself.
So Marie still has lots to do to win the £1,000 prize. Anyway, getting back to business.
Oh, God.
Who's gone? Lives?
God, it's...
Oh, I wonder what that is.
It's Alan.
Alan! Oh, God, honestly. Hi, it's Alan Sugar. He's... Welcome. Welcome. OK, Alan, come in. Come in, Alan. Hi, he's coming in now. Just a minute. OK, hi.
The union gentleman.
Get a job on X Factor.
See, he says businessman.
I just thought the woman's mental. Oh, words fail me.
I was kind of hoping to knock the damn thing over and then tread on it accidentally, because, quite frankly, it was pointless.
Vera, you're fired. Marie has one last chance to impress her guests with her two desserts. And how about that ice cream?
I didn't make it till 12 o'clock today. And it's set.
For pudding, Marie's serving lemon syllabub and meringue with homemade elderflower ice cream.
Remind me, what is it? This is meringue with...
Elderflower ice cream.
Elderflower.
It just tasted like a massage oil to me. And the ice cream was also very runny.
Meringue and ice cream and a few bits of fruit. You know, you're looking for a bit more excitement. You know, after all, it's a cooking competition.
The meringue, I've tasted better.
Blimey, that's scathing coming from Vera. But our host remains as confident as ever, so much so she decides to start singing.
I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. Oh, I'm crazy for thinking that my love would hold you. I'm crazy for crying and crazy for trying.
Is that the coffee or the singing?
And I'm crazy for loving you.
Don't you start.
Bravo. Bravo. Excellent. You have a beautiful voice, Marie.
Can I be Simon Cowell here? And yes. Say, quite frankly, that moved me to the point where I needed another drink. However, you have talent. I don't think you got the X Factor. I hope that you're not. I hope I don't get the older group, but you're through to boot camp.
You okay, John? What's got into you lot tonight?
Cheers, young man. Cheers.
That was very nice, actually. You have a wonderful voice.
Thank you.
She's got a wonderful voice, but, you know, it's not the sort of thing that floats my boat.
And it seems John's week-long rant behind Marie's back is playing on his conscience.
There's one person around this table that I have made a certain amount of not malicious or nasty comments, but I have been quite forthright with my feelings towards him. And after tonight, I hold my hands up and say that I think I've just made a big mistake. I don't think that person is at all like I thought they were. But I won't tell you who it is.
Come on, you chicken, tell her. Tell her!
as I'm the hostess tonight, do we accept his apology?
Yes, we do.
We do. What about you, James?
Or Jimmy, shall we call you Jimmy now we know you?
We shall wait and see the footage before we see if we accept James' apology.
Yeah, because I know who it is. You've done really well.
Thank you.
I'll be the first
to say that. Hope I haven't poisoned you all.
Well, if you have, it's been a nice poison.
Right, OK. I know who John was talking about, and it was me. I just know it was. And I really appreciate him admitting that he was wrong.
Marie's not daft. Yeah, she knows that, you know, it's come to the end of the week and John's probably after an invite back to the mansion.
I don't try to be controversial. I just want people to like me.
Despite everything, Marie still reckons she can beat James's 22 points.
I wouldn't give myself 10 because things weren't perfect, you know, and it's a bit slightly slow on my recommendation, what I would normally do. I'd say about 8 would be about right.
I would say I preferred Marie's cooking over John's cooking, but I preferred the ambience of John's dinner party. So it's one up, one down. So I'm giving Marie the same score, which is an 8.
Going to be a 4 for Marie.
I found bones in her fish cakes. On her main course, the potato puree was just your bog standard mashed potato, and also the 3 cabbage was like kebab cabbage, and her dessert was tasteless and runny.
Ouch.
So dinner party addict Marie is barely ahead of Vera with 17 points. And it's down to her to reveal who wins the £1,000 prize.
There you go, guys.
Money shot.
Money shot, that's right. In fourth place, it begins with V, it's Vera.
Thank you.
And in third place, we have Marie.
Oh. Well done, Marie.
And in second place, we have John. Well done, John.
Well done, mate. Congratulations.
Yeah. Cheers, thanks.
Well deserved.
And in first place, it's James. Well done, James.
Well done, mate.
Well done. I'm feeling a little disappointed that I didn't win, but whatever. It doesn't matter. Whatever, as all the grandkids would say, whatever.
It's not about winning, not for me anyhow. It's about just doing it, really. Yeah, I've enjoyed it.
I would love to do it all over again because... In actual fact, just invite back next week. I'll pretend I live somewhere else in the country. I'll grow a beard and a little moustache or something and wear a pair of dark glasses. And I'll try to win a second time around.
I'm going to spend the money frivolously, I should imagine, on little treats myself and the kids. I might even get myself a new set of golf clubs.